Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Dr. Aisha Munk. I'm a psychologist, neuroscientist, and medical doctor with a deep passion for understanding what makes life truly fulfilling. Today, we're discussing a topic that resonates with everyone, regardless of age, background, or personal circumstances. How can we live happier, more satisfying lives? Happiness is not just a fleeting emotion, it's a skill we can cultivate. Martin Seligman, the founder of positive psychology, has revolutionized the way we think about happiness by exploring the science of well-being. In this video, I'll take you through the core principles of positive psychology, share insights from fascinating studies, and provide practical tips that you can start using today to create a more joyful and purposeful life. Whether you're feeling stuck, searching for greater meaning, or just looking for small ways to enhance your everyday experience, this video is for you. So grab a notebook or a cup of tea and let's dive into the science of happiness. What is positive psychology? Before we jump into the strategies, let's explore what positive psychology is all about and how it differs from traditional psychology. Traditional psychology often focuses on diagnosing and treating mental illnesses, such as depression or anxiety. While this is incredibly important, positive psychology shifts the focus from what's wrong to what's right. It's about studying and fostering the factors that allow individuals, communities, and organizations to thrive. Martin Seligman, an American psychologist and one of the pioneers of this field, asked a simple yet profound question. What makes life worth living? His work focuses on uncovering what drives human flourishing, not just surviving, but thriving. To make this concept more accessible, Seligman developed the PERMA model, a framework for well-being that highlights five key elements. First, positive emotions. These include feelings like joy, gratitude, and hope. Experiencing positive emotions regularly helps us build resilience and cope better with life's challenges. Second, engagement. This is the state of being fully absorbed in an activity. Have you ever been so immersed in something that you just lost track of time? That's engagement, also known as flow. Relationships. Human connection is at the heart of a fulfilling life. Building supportive, meaningful relationships with others is one of the strongest predictors of happiness. Fourth, meaning or purpose. Having a sense of purpose or contributing to something greater than ourselves gives life direction and significance. Fifth, achievements. Accomplishing goals and celebrating our successes, big or small, helps us feel a sense of progress and self-worth. Together, these pillars form a roadmap for leading a fulfilling life. Positive psychology encourages us to actively nurture these elements regardless of where we are on our personal journey. Seligman didn't just theorize about happiness. He backed his ideas with scientific research, offering us concrete strategies to improve our well-being. Let's look at two of his most impactful studies. One of his most well-known exercises is the three good things practice. Here's how it works. At the end of each day, participants write down three positive events they experienced, no matter how small, and explain why they found them meaningful. For example, I enjoyed a delicious cup of coffee in the morning because it gave me a moment of peace before my busy day started. Or, I received a kind message from a friend which made me feel appreciated. Or, I finished a challenging task at work and it felt great to achieve something I'd been struggling with. The results were stunning. Participants who completed this exercise for just 1 week reported increased happiness and reduced depressive symptoms, with the positive effects lasting for months. This shows that even small shifts in focus can have a profound impact. Another fascinating study emphasized the power of gratitude. In this experiment, participants wrote gratitude letters to people who had made a positive difference in their lives. They didn't even need to send the letters. Just the act of reflecting on their gratitude significantly boosted their emotional well-being. Those who expressed their gratitude openly experienced even greater benefits, reinforcing the importance of meaningful connections. Now that we have explored the science, let's turn these insights into actionable steps you can take to improve your own life. Here are five practical strategies grounded in positive psychology. Practice gratitude. Gratitude is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it gets. Each evening, take 5 to 10 minutes to reflect on three things you're grateful for. It doesn't have to be something grand. Even small moments like a sunny day or a kind gesture count. For example, I'm grateful for the laughter I shared with a colleague today. I'm thankful for the delicious dinner I cooked. I appreciate that I had the time to read a good book. Over time, this simple practice rewires your brain to focus on the positive, leading to lasting improvements in your mood and outlook. Second, cultivate positive relationships. Humans are social beings and our relationships deeply influence our happiness. Make an effort to spend time with people who uplift and support you. This could mean reconnecting with an old friend, scheduling regular family dinners, or simply expressing appreciation to a loved one. Small acts, like sending a thoughtful message or saying thank you, can strengthen your connections and create a ripple effect of positivity. Third, identify and use your strengths. Take some time to reflect on your unique strengths. Are you empathetic, creative, or a great problem solver? Once you identify these qualities, find ways to use them in your daily life. For example, if you're naturally empathetic, consider volunteering or mentoring. If you're creative, channel that into art, writing, or design. Using your strengths gives you a sense of purpose and fulfillment. Fourth, seek flow experiences. Think about the activities that make you lose track of time. This could be anything from playing an instrument to gardening or running. These flow experiences not only bring you joy, but also reduce stress and increase your overall sense of well-being. Fifth, find meaning in your life. Take a step back and ask yourself, what gives my life meaning? Could be your family, your career, or a cause you're passionate about. Pursuing something bigger than yourself provides a sense of direction and resilience, especially during challenging times. The field of positive psychology reminds us that happiness and well-being aren't random. They're skills that we can cultivate. By focusing on gratitude, relationships, strengths, engagement, and meaning, we can take control of our mental and emotional health. I encourage you to try one of these strategies we discussed today. Which one resonated with you the most? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear about your experiences. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more science-based tips, and share this video with someone who could use it. Could use a little positivity in their life. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.